Hi, welcome to Enchiridion. I am very excited to share with you these facts on Meiolania. Meiolania was a stem turtle from the Middle Miocene and Late Pleistocene, and possibly Holocene. When first described from fossil skulls, Meiolania was believed to have been a lizard, hence the name which means small roamer. This reflects an earlier description of Megalania, today known as Varanus priscus, which means great roamer, and was also named by Owen in 1859. The genus was erected in 1886 based on remains discovered on Lord Howe Island, which Richard Owen assigned to the two species of Meiolania platyceps and Meiolania minor, which is now a synonym of the former. These were the first good Meiolanid remains, and were used to show that the first known remains of a related animal, a species from Queensland, now known as Ninjemys oweni, which was assigned to Meiolania until 1992, did not belong to lizards as initially thought, but to turtles. Woodward sank Niolamia, argentina into Meiolania, but this was not accepted by later authors. Later on, it was learned that Meiolania was actually a terrestrial turtle, and one of, if not the largest, terrestrial turtle to live. In New Caledonia, Meiolania macayi was described from Walpole Island in 1925. It was smaller and less robust than a Meiolania platyceps. Meiolania remains are also known from the Pindai Caves, Grande Terre, and from Taiga Island. Meiolania rubicollis was described in 1992 from the mid-Miocene Camfield beds of northern Australia, and differed from Meiolania platyceps in having a flatter skull and other horn proportions. A second undescribed species of Meiolania from mainland Australia is known from the Wyandotte Creek locality in Queensland, dated to the Late Pleistocene, consisting of three horn cores and a caudal vertebra, noted to be unusually large in size. This species is referred to as Meiolania cf. Platyceps, as the remains are most similar to Meiolania platyceps, but are not diagnostic beyond genus level. Holocene remains of turtles from Vanuatu found in Lepidoculture middens were referred to Meiolania in 2010 as the new species Meiolania damalepi. However, upon closer inspection, their morphology appears to be non-melaniform, and no parietal horns, a distinctive trait of Meiolania, have been found at any locality in Vanuatu, despite being one of the most common finds on Walpole and Lord Howe. The long bone morphology agrees more closely with the tortoise identification, a group which has otherwise not been reported from the South Pacific of Australasia. Further remains attributable to Meiolania damalepi, or a closely related form, have been found in various parts of the Fijian archipelago, including Bidi Lebu, Banualebu, and some smaller islands. Meiolania species come in a number of sizes, but smaller specimens are usually attributed to smaller island populations, something that could be attributed to insular dwarfism. The larger specimens of Meiolania are estimated at up to 8.2 feet or 250 centimeters long, and despite the fact that some aquatic turtles like Argalon were bigger, Meiolania is the second biggest known land-living turtle. The only real rival that Meiolania has in terms of size is the giant colossal chelys from Asia, which is estimated between 8.2 and 9 feet, or 250 and 275 centimeters long. Although we know that Meiolania was a turtle, we still don't know what type. Turtles are classified as either being members of the cryptodira, which fold their necks under their spines, or the pleurodira, group of turtles that fold their necks to their sides. However, Meiolania couldn't do either of these things, because of the arrangement of spikes on top of its skull that would have prevented the head from sliding under the shell. Despite this, however, the Meiolanidae family of turtles, which Meiolania belongs to, is still grouped under Cryptodira. Meiolania had an unusually shaped skull that sported many horn-like and knob-like protrusions. Two large horns faced sideways, and would have prevented the animal fully withdrawing its head into its shell. The tail was protected by armored rings, and sported thorn-like spikes at the end. The body form of Meiolania converts towards those of dinosaur and ankylosaurids and xenarthran glyptodonts. Aside from the large spikes on its head, Meiolania also had a spiked tail similar to some tails of the mammalian glyptodonts, and it's possible that these may have been defensive features for protecting the head and the tail extremities from predators. Such adaptations would have made it hard for predators to close their mouths around these spots without getting a mouthful of spikes. There are two species of Meiolania known from the Australian continent, Meiolania rubicollis, and an unnamed species, The unnamed species could reach 6.6 feet or 2 meters in carapace length, making it the second largest known non-marine turtle or tortoise, surpassed only by Megalochelys atlas from Asia, which lived in the Pleistocene. The smallest species in turn was Meiolania macaii from New Caledonia, with a carapace length of 2.3 feet or 70 centimeters. Another insular species is known from Lord Howe Island, Meiolania platyceps. Meiolania fed on plants. Because the remains known by 1925 were found close to beaches, it was thought to be aquatic. It is now known to have been terrestrial. Nonetheless, a more recent study shows that they were in fact coastal species that occupied a niche similar to that of the modern marine iguana. The disappearance of much of the Pleistocene megafauna is often attributed to the arrival of humans, and in the case of Meiolania, there is actually strong evidence to support this view. In Vanuatu, the remains of the species Meiolania damalipi have been found in the rubbish dumps of early human settlements. Most of these remains are of leg bones, which strongly suggests that the body of the animal was butchered elsewhere, possibly at the site of the kill, and more manageable parts like the legs were brought back for later consumption. Study of the layers of these rubbish deposits also points to an event where Meiolania went extinct only 300 years after the first human contact. This fate was nearly shared by the Galapagos tortoise, Chelonoidis nigra, following the arrival of the first Europeans on the Galapagos Islands. Additionally, it is thought the Meiolania platyceps went extinct on Lord Howe Island before human occupation as a result of post-glacial sea level rise. Meiolania means small roamer. It was named by Richard Owen in 1886. It belongs to the kingdom Animalia, the phylum Chordata, the class Reptilia, the family Meiolaniidae, and the genus Meiolania. Synonyms include Meiolania and Ceratocellus. Species include the type Meiolania platyceps, and other species like Meiolania brevicaulis, the Melipi, and Macaii. It was a herbivore. For smaller species found on smaller islands, like Meiolania macaii, the carapace length was about 2.3 feet, or 70 centimeters. On the other hand, carapace length for some individuals of larger species from the main continent could approach 6.6 feet, or 2 meters. Average total body length for most individuals from the main Australian continent was about 8.2 feet, or 2.5 meters. It has been discovered in Australia and some of the outlying islands like New Caledonia, Lord Howe Island, and Vanuatu, among others. Some fossils from Bidi Lebu have also been identified. It lived in terrestrial and channel environments. It lived during the Oligocene to Holocene, 15.97 million years to 12,000 years ago. It disappeared around 1 before present era. Fossil representation includes numerous specimens. And with that, thank you for watching. I remember watching the Walking with Dinosaurs series when I was younger, and that really inspired me to make these paleontology videos. I was recently selected as a moderator for the Science of Paleontology Today group on Facebook, which is a great feat. Thank you so much. Thank you for your support. It makes me happy and keeps me going. And as always, thank you for watching. This is Enchiridion. See you next time.